plane. So this will be the top reference plane. The gap from the top into the edge of the round corner, we will set the dimensions to 50. Set to 50. Lock the dimension. Also from here, from the bottom, we will set the dimension to 50. Set the dimension 50. Then lock it in place. So now we will draw the flexible duct collector from the center. So in order to do that, create extrusion, select circle, select and create the circle based on the dimension. Let's do that first, 65. Activate the dimension. Then we need to label this as the, create the parameter as the duct radius. So now go to the extrusion, finish the extrusion. So now basically this will adjust automatically based on these radius. So this one we have to label this as duct radius. So once we adjust the duct radius, it will automatically adjust based on the dimensions of the flexible. So we type first 65, let's say 100. We haven't locked this top of the plenum box, so we have to create a line and then lock it. So now we try it again. Let's say 75. So now it's automatically adjusting. The height of the plenum box will automatically adjust based on the size of the flexible round. So now we go to the reference plane and then we adjust this duct connector size to around 50 mm extension for the connection of the flexible duct. This top of the round extrusion will flush it into the edge of the plenum box. Click align, reference level, lock. This one you can simply create another reference plane, dimension it at 50 mm, lock the constraint. So now it's already 51, let's set the correct size. Little bit difficult to select now. Okay. Okay, now we align it first and then lock. Now this one we have to check how. Okay, sometimes it's play around with me. So we unlock it first, select, then now we can change 50. Then push it back and then lock it. Okay, so now let's push it back. So now as you can see in the 3D view, we have the flexible duct connector which can we can set the size to change to either 150, 200, 250 to 300. So the height of the plenum box will adjust automatically based on the size of this flexible duct connector. So now we have to create the duct connector, select the face, and then click the arrow, change this to bound. Then we will associate the diameter to the, oh, we have to create another parameter for the duct diameter. So in order to do that, we have to go back to the front, set another label for diameter, create the label duct diameter. Click this as instance. Then we go back to the connector, we associate this as a duct diameter. So it takes the size of this diameter and then translate it into this parameter. So basically this is a preset, this one is into the grill, supplier, loss method with specific loss. Click apply. Now you have created your own first supply ceiling diffuser. So now in order for us to identify it in the plan, we have to place some symbolic or lines to show that this is a three slot diffuser. So we go to the reference plane, reference level, then we need to go back to the front. Let's name this reference level as face. We have to draw within this reference line, so it will, the symbols will be locked within this reference plane, and when we adjust this, it will automatically follow this reference plane. So let's go to the reference level, create, set reference level space, click OK. Now we can draw the symbol, annotate symbolic lines, go to the rectangular first, square, then the single line, one slot, two slot. We can have this move around, let's say 32. This one will be around 33. Okay, so it's slightly, let's say this one is another 33. So the center one will be a little bit bigger. So these three lines represents the three slot diffuser, the gaps opening where the air will flow out of the grill. So if we look at the 3D view, now we will load this into an open project so you can see if the symbolic line will be visible in the project. So load into project. On the earthen system, earthen selectability, center, as you can see, the symbolic line which shows the three slot diffuser can be seen and it's visible. So now you have created your own first air terminal three slot ceiling diffuser non-hosted. Hope this tutorial will be helpful. Please subscribe and share, and click the notification button. Thank you.